Hello viewers, thanks for watching. In this video I'm going to be making yam pottage. To make yam pottage I'm going to be using yam, so I'm going to be cutting half of this yam. I'm also going to be blending my scotch bonnets and tomatoes together. So I need scotch bonnets and one tin of tomato and onions, so I'll be blending the three together. Now I've got tomato paste there, that is 70 grams of tomato paste. This is grounded crayfish. I'm going to be using some grounded crayfish. I've got some prawns here, fresh prawns, quite lovely, just brought out from the freezer. I'm going to use this to measure my palm oil, so I'm going to be using 125 ml of palm oil, just for you to understand the accuracy of what to measure, because you might not have, for viewers who need to know the accurate measurement of that. So I'm going to be using some dried shrimps as well, which is not blended yet. Of course I'll be needing some salt, so I'll be adding some salt. You might want to add sugar to yours, you know, people add sugar to their yam pottage, but you know, keep it simple. I'm going to be using probably 2 tablespoons of this in my yam pottage. So let's get started. All right, the first thing I'm going to do is to slice this yam, and I'm going to use, as I say, I'm going to be using half of this. So I'm going to be cutting the yam into cubes, and yes, so that's what I'm going to be doing. So just slice the yam and cut it into cubes. You can see the yam is freshly chopped now into cubes, and I've actually rinsed them. So I'm going to be pouring this into the pot to cook while I blend my tomato, onions, and scotch bonnets. So I'm just going to pour that in. You want to make sure that water is covering the yam while it cooks. That's it. 1 tablespoon of salt into that. Put on that and cover it to cook. Right, it's because I'm using a pressure cooker, I'm going to allow it to cook for 10 minutes. So after 10 minutes, I'm going to check. Right, at this point, I want to blend my tomatoes. So I'm going to pour in 1 tin of tomato right in there. 3 scotch bonnets, I'll pour it inside. I'm just going to slice my onions. Just cut them so it can blend properly. Goes in there, cover it, and now in the middle of that, before you finish blending, I'm going to add too, and that gives it extra flavor. So continue blending. That's it. I don't want it to be too blended inside, so I think that's absolutely what I want. So it's over 10 minutes now. I'm just gonna check. Let's bring that to cool down. Fantastic. Just gonna check. Brilliant. It's well cooked. So this has been cooking for 10 minutes. So I'm just gonna drain some of the water away, because it's right too much for your tomato sauce. So you have to make sure that the water's level is okay when you pour your tomato. You don't want too much water in your yam. So I'm gonna drain that away and just allow a little bit so the tomato blend can cook properly when I put it back. I've drained some of the water away. I'll put it back. Put on your the back on there. So what I'm going to do next, half of this, I'm not going to finish it, half of my blended one tomato is what I'm going to use. I'm just going to pour half into it. As you can see, I have some left. I'll add my prawns, my tomato paste, which is 70 grams. Thank you. my string, just one spoon, remember I've blended some. I'm gonna mix 125 ml of palm oil. Pour that inside. And I say, I'll just mix that and leave that to cook. I'm going to be adding 1 tablespoon of chicken condiments. I'm going to mix for around 8 to 10 minutes to cook. Then I'm gonna match some of the yam to just make it blended, and the color, as you can see, it's all looking great. Right, I'm gonna check now. It's been cooking for around 6 minutes. Just gonna mash some of the yam, and that's what gives it the name Asaro, which is mashed yam pottage. At this point now, I'm just gonna lower the heat and allow that to simmer for another probably 3 minutes. Then it's ready to serve. Can you see that? It's great. Right, as I can see, it's ready now. Yeah, that's Asaro. Thanks for watching. Well, thank you very much for watching the video. I know you must have enjoyed watching the video, the yam pottage. Please, you know, make your own yam pottage and post videos. Leave some comments, that would be great. And I look forward to seeing you in my next video. Thank you so much for watching, and see you. Bye-bye.